And if you could zoom your screen a bit, it will be very helpful for browser page.
Is it fine now? It is reducing.
Maybe you need to zoom in my screen because you will be taking through Git and code.
So I'm zooming out.
Yeah, it's better.
It's better. Okay. So in today, in this session, I'll cover about like what is localization, how it works, how can we add a new language, and how will we store the key and values for that individual languages. Okay. So basically, again, localization is a core service in our Digit platform. So it enables our application to run in different local languages. So we store the data in the form of key value pairs, along with the module name, tenant ID, and the locale. Okay. So these details will be posted via REST APIs. So we have create, update, fetch, delete API supported from the MDMS service. So we use this APIs to push the localization data. And whatever data posted, that will be permanently stored in DB. It is not a MDMS data. So these data will be stored in the database. So once the application loaded, we will load all this localization data into the Redis cache. Okay. Whenever we load the new data, this cache will be refreshed. So the first step is like, we'll see how the languages, where we are defining these languages. Again, this set of languages is a MDMS data. So yesterday I showed in MDMS, the base folder common master. So we have a state info JSON. So again, this is a state level info. So here under state info JSON, we have a section called languages. So here we will mention the list of the languages which we are supporting. So if you want to add one more new language, it will be like one more addition in this array, comma separated, comma, one more new language. So by default, the English language will be supported from the product. Okay, but facility will be provided to add values for different languages. So here currently in Uttarakhand, we have English, Hindi, and Kannada for some testing purpose we have added. So the values are there for these two languages, English and Hindi. So here label the language name and the value is the locale. Okay. And these are for other purposes. So basically, if we are adding a new language, one entry should be made in stateinfo.json under this language section.
So the remaining part is there, below that we won't be using that, or we will be, it will be common. We will be accessing through your servers, okay? Localization module.
No. You will be adding it. So we are providing along with this modules, which are localized. There is some user manual section where if you want to support enable manuals language wise. So that detail we are providing here. So for module TL, we have a manuals in Hindi as well as in English. Here we store it. The same single file will not be converted into Hindi English on change of language. So we will keep different files with different languages in a file store. So that location based on the language, we will mention it here. So if we are adding one more language XYZ, and if we are adding a manual for that language, so here we will add a one more addition. Okay. The manual link in that language will be added here. So whenever I'm using TL in particular language, and whenever I fetch the manual of that, so in that language, it will be shown. Okay.
Okay.
So currently we have TL and PT. And for those two, we have pushed English and Hindi manual for both the modules. And those details are kept here.
Okay.
These are all not mandatory. If you have manual, these details, it should be mentioned here. Okay. But for languages to be enabled, this is the mandatory one.
Okay. So this localization modules are there, which is again, for each and every module, there is a different language. Below this. Line number 33. This is for?
This is for like which all modules are localized. So almost all
okay,
the
so
modules
it may,
will be,
it may yeah. be possible that our half of the modules like TL is converted into Hindi and English, but property tax is not something like that.
It's like all these modules are by default English will be enabled. Okay.
Okay.
So, and you can localize these modules in other languages on the set of.
Okay. So
okay,
whatever
that facility may be provided.
So whatever the module having this facility, we have to mention this.
Yes.
Otherwise, it will be remain in English only.
In English, yes. See here on. So when you log in, you will get a language selection tab. So if there are no multiple languages, by defaultly it will pick English and it will directly go into the login page. Okay. If there are more number of languages, it will be prompted to this language selection screen. So here we have Hindi, English, Kannada, and you can see Hindi is by defaultly chosen, highlighted. So this info again, it comes from this file itself. So here we are mentioning the default language as HINI. This is nothing but the locale of Hindi language. Okay. So if I mention here English, when you log in, this English language will be highlighted. Means by defaultly it will be selected. Okay. So for UK, we wanted Hindi to be by defaultly selected. So it was mentioned as Hindi there. So I'll choose English. So here, okay, I'll come to this part later. Continue. So all this are coming in English. Okay, if we switch to Hindi, everything will show up in Hindi. Okay, this is actually an image. Okay, so it will remain in same English. So the other details are in Hindi. If you choose Hindi, all the details will be shown up in Hindi. So how this data loading is done language wise? I'll see. So continue. So here in our application, we have a provision that there is no limitation that while in the beginning of the application only, whatever language we choose, that should stay till the end. So in between also, we can switch the language. So after login, you can see here, it shows up. Currently, whatever the language selected is English, and it lists all the languages that are enabled. So here in between, we can switch English to Hindi or some other language. It will refresh. Okay, it will show up in the chosen language. Okay. So how this data loading happens when we switch from English to Hindi, how the details will be changed. So there is a, as I said, we store the details, this locale data in the form of key value pairs, and it comes from the database. You can see we have pushed for UK the values for English and Hindi, not for Kannada. So if I choose Kannada, it will show up keys because it does not have any values pushed. Okay. So if we push values for this keys, then it will show up the values in Kannada. So basically the screens end to end for each and every field, there will be a key defined. And for that key, we will push the values in different languages. Based on the language chosen, it will show up that value if there is a value in the DB. If there is no value entries there in the DB, it will show up the keys that are coded. Okay, and there is a naming convention to code this, to form this codes. So here there are different fields. So few will come from MDMS. For example, if you choose English, if you see trade license, see, these are all like the fixed details, search, trade license, applications also. So these are all MDMS data, as I explained yesterday. Okay, so here these details are from MDMS. These are coded in UI. And now the screen has a mix of MDMS data as well as the UI data. So the localization should be defined for both. So if I change to Hindi, so these keys, this field names, and then the field, the drop-down values are also changed. If I change it to Kannada, see there is no value defined for this freezed text or the field header or this MDMS data. So for each and everything, we need to have a localized data pushed in the DB. Okay, so that data, when we say it, so it will have MDMS data, all the master data. So then the fixed values, then headers, button names, all this. So there is a format to define this codes. For example, if we see create trade license, this is an application type header. We say trade license, the module name, and the header, that label, application underscore type or application type underscore. Since it is a header, we mention it as label. So everywhere you can see it is a label. So on all the MDMS keys are with underscores. So we will not entertain TL dot, new dot, something like that. So it should be separated. The spaces should be separated, mentioned as underscores. Okay, so and then the code for to load the MDMS data, we have a specific format. MDMS. See here, so this application type, we have new and renewal, new and renewal. Okay, so again in MDMS yesterday I mentioned that these codes, only the unique codes will have added here. The values, the actual values for these will come from the localization. So here for application type dot new means it is new and renewal. The values are new and renewal. So the values we have pushed for these codes in English, in Hindi, but in Kannada it is not pushed. So how the code is formed is the module name trade license. So for MDMS it goes like this. After the UK, that is state folder, whatever follows up, that will be considered for forming the key for localization. So the module name trade license underscore this master name, application type, okay, and whatever the unique key we are mentioning for that master. So if it is code, so here we are using code as a unique key. So what is the value for that code is application type dot new. So dot we are replacing with underscore. So this is the code format. And there will be a value pushed for this code. So if we see some other masters, say occupancy type, again occupancy type dot wound. So here you can see same trade license, it is the module name after the state, and the master name occupancy type, everything will be in caps. And then the code, whichever the unique key we are using for that master. So here it is occupancy type dot wound, that we are replacing with underscore. So if there are no, if it is straightforward like just wound, then it will be like occupancy type underscore wound. I will show some other value. Okay, so we have structure type under common masters. So which is a common master for all other modules, which is not module specific. So you can see structure type. So here we have immovable shed, immovable shop, immovable godown. So this is one more use case where this is not a complete code for it. Here we have a parent-child relationship. So the shed is a structure subtype and this is a structure type. Okay, so instead of keeping two MDMS files, so we are having that relationship here only. So structure type, whatever the distinct first level values, we will take it as structure type. So the second level would be a substructure type. So here, while pushing the data for structure, we will form the code till the first level. So here, it begins with common masters. After the state level, whatever the folder name here we have, it is with hyphen, we replace it with underscore. Then the master name, structure type, underscore, it is ending with just immovable, not immovable underscore shed, because this is the parent dropdown. So we have immovable, movable. So as I said, it will pick the distinct first value, movable and immovable. So if you choose immovable, so the child dropdown gets loaded here. Okay, so here it shows up complete. Common master, structure type, immovable workshop. So we have immovable.shed. So similarly, same way, immovable open LAN garage, immovable underscore shop. So if it is movable, so it loads. Okay, and whatever this watermarked label is shown, it is just a help text. So like this, to say enter old license number, enter operational area, so and so. So this is the this watermarked one is an help text. So again, everything will be localized. So again, this will have a key and there should be a value pushed for this. Okay. So for MDMS, this is the naming convention to create a keys. So irrespective of modules and masters. So that is the naming convention we follow. So that if you are adding one more new master or a new value, you should remember that entry should be made in the localization. Okay, otherwise it will show up only keys. Okay. So if we add any one new type for this and we have not pushed any actual message for it, it will show that one more key after the new one.
But it will show, I mean, my point is...
It will show. Okay. Yeah.
So underscore, that part is designed automatically based on the path, right?
Yes. Okay. It will show up like this.
Okay.
Okay, then you need to push the value in whichever language you want. So currently, as I said, we have endpoints to push all these values. So recently, our UI lead Murli has developed a screens, okay, to search, fetch, update, delete, and then create these messages. So I'll show both. So we have create endpoint, update endpoint, delete endpoint, which are used. Okay. So yeah, the contracts and all you can find in that service. So currently we have create to create a new code, and then update, which updates the message of the existing code. And recently we have added one more API called upsert. So which does both update as well as insert. What it means is it'll find for, it'll check for this code. If this code is already exist, it'll update that message. If that code is not present, it'll make an insertion. So it'll does the operation of creation as well as updation. So hence the name upsert. Okay, and then we have a delete API where we can take out the message. Okay. So the whenever you create, see here, now I will search localization message. I will say the parameters to be passed are which language, VNIN. Okay. We need to pass the auth token. So I will generate auth token here. I'm copying the auth token and here. Yeah. See. So this API reads the data from the table. So we have a table called message table. So which holds these many columns, key, value is nothing but the message, actual value, and then the module, which module it belongs to, and then locale, and the tenant ID. Okay. So why we are keeping this tenant ID is, we have, again, I said in MDMS, we have state level data as well as ULB level data, right? See these common masters, trade license properties, these are all like state level data, which are same across all ULBs. So we have few data which are specific to each ULBs. For example, location. Location, that boundary data, so property tax also, like few fields like interest, rebate, penalty, it varies from ULB to ULB. Okay, so those are all like transactional data which does not require any localization data to be pushed. These are all transactional data which are used for calculation purpose. So there will be few data which we show up in the screen, like boundary, that mohallas, as well as in trades, we have that category, trade type and subtype. Here, these fields. Okay, so these are ULB specific. So hence, these are mentioned under each ULB in that module. So the localization values for this should be pushed for that ULB. See here, tenant ID UK means it will show up all the data which are pushed state level, which are common to the all the ULBs. If I say UK dot Dehradun, it will show up the data pushed for that tenant. So this is the code M01. This is the boundary location code and this is the value. Okay, again the module names should be UK.Dehradun. So it means that these localization keys are for this ULB. Okay, so here we have revenue and then Mohallas M001. This is the locality. So for this locality in the dropdown, what value should be shown? So it will be formed like this. The boundary, the hierarchy would be like this. The ULB name, state ULB, and this is the boundary, whether it is revenue or admin, and the Mohalla code. Okay, for that we are pushing messages, and these values remain same for all others. So the code should be unique. So if you see, the same will not be there for other ULBs. And remember, this tenant ID, this name is the same as the name which we mentioned in the tenants.json. So if any variation in the spelling or it is case sensitive, any changes, it will not show up. So here no result. Okay. So it will, this, whatever the boundary data pertaining to Haldwani, it is pushed under uk.haldwani. Okay. If you search in the state level, say state level in the sense, we will send value as UK. Okay, so it is not pushed here. By mistake, if you push it at state level, these values, still it will not refer from the state level. It always looks under uk.dehradun. It will try to query this message table by passing that specific ULB tenant ID. Okay, this is one more point. So the localization messages should also be pushed at state level for all the state level data, and ULB level for all the ULB level data. Any confusions here? Is it clear?
Yeah. This means request part always, it's request info is there, right? So it will be always be there, right? And like this only we have to send whenever we are making a new request.
Yes. So okay. In this auth token is the main thing.
Other thing means date and time can vary, right? Or it has to be updated.
It will not take a read on this. The main thing is the auth token. So you can see the contract for request info, what all details are mandatory or non-mandatory. Based on that, you can include here. Okay. And then here you can add few more filters also, or else that can be part of the below this request portion. So UK, then now I will see. Okay, English, fine. So we will see value for this, how it is pushed. Multiple tabs. See language, KNIN. There is no data, hence it is showing the K. Okay, now I will see ENIN. See, there is one data, language. You can see in the screen. Okay, language. So for in Hindi, it is meaning that Bhasha. So for this, again, there is a value pushed for that key. Okay. So that we need to search. Locale should be HIIN. For Hindi. Okay. So again, what, this module name, if you see.
What is it you are using to convert the language? Using the Google API, translation API, or the
Google Translate probably. But this data will be validated from our team, and they will provide the corrected values in case. Sometimes the Google Translator also will not give this English to Hindi complete proper word. So we use the translator only.
And as such, in right now in the service, MDMS service, in the private DB for Hindi and English, both will be by default configured, or here, SSN product wise, it's only English is mentioned.
As product wise, English is mentioned, but they will give this provision. They will add it. They will give a placeholder like this code. So for this code, we need to push the Hindi value. But from product, English will be there.
Hindi SS is not there, or Hindi is again. I mean, it's not a part of product.
No, they That's will not push TV. All those TV. Values. Hindi.
Okay.
Yeah. So here you can see the module is Rainmaker Common. That is because these details are from Common Masters and it is common, not specific to any ULB. So the module name. If we see UK.Dehradun, then the module name would be Rainmaker underscore that TL, which were UK.Dehradun, which were ULB specific. So you can assume that if it shows up code in the UI, it means that there is no message pushed for that language. Okay. So I will push. There is no value for this. I will add it. So this is search endpoint. I will use the upsert, which will does creation also if there is no existing message it finds. So I will do it in. Again, message is an array. You can pass at one shot a number of messages. Verify that locale. What is the locale we have mentioned?
Multi.
Yeah.
Actually, you are pushing the data from the services only, no? So
from
the when we have to start, right? That time we have to push some data and all, no? That time how you are pushing to the database,
like
localization code part and all to the database you are pushing, no?
So it will automatically read. You need not restart this localization service whenever you make one new entry. Okay, if you refresh.
No, when we deploy our application, right? So that time we need to push some data to the database because we have the JSON data here. The corresponding code should be there in the Postgres database, right?
Yes. So when you start the service or application, whatever the existing messages in the table will be loaded.
She is saying for initial setup time.
The initial setup as part of Flyway, English will be there, right?
Through Flyway, you are loading the data.
By default, English will be there. Okay. So additionally,
by default, pushing, no, using Flyway, you are pushing the data to the Postgres.
That I need to verify, but it will be there in the Flyway. As new features also, yeah, it will be there in the Flyway only. Other languages, it won't be part of the Flyway. We have to push it through JSON using endpoints.
That's what I was asking, when for Uttarakhand, when you have already done the Hindi part. So means at some level, the Hindi part converts, some level, some data we can, it will be quite static and it will be common for, if I say the category wise, maybe, category may change, but remaining part, the logo name or bhasha and all that, can you keep it in your product only so that whenever we are even fetching it, we will be having some default configuration for Hindi also.
Okay.
And one more thing, in this JSON, whichever you are showing, right, we have the default URL. So whenever we select any language, it is going to the corresponding login page, right?
Yes.
So in between also you told we can change the language, no? So
yes.
That configuration is where when in between if we change, because it has to retain the same state there.
It will retain the same state, only the what the language, readable language will change. The state will not change.
Where is that JSON part? Like here you have like redirected. Okay, once I select the language, you go to the login page, right? So once I log in, I have an English, then I will change the language to Hindi. That time only this localization part you are changing. Other page content, you are retaining the same. Correct? How you are handling this part?
This will be handled in the UI itself. So again, this is a language drop down. Okay. So on change of the language, one endpoint will be copied to load all these keys in that particular choose the language.
Can you show in the UI how like you have done this localization?
Through UI, you want to see how to push the code and then delete?
Yeah, you are showing like JSON, right? Like that. Can you show in
through
the
Postman
code
instead of that you wanted to see in UI? Yeah.
If I be very specific, I think she is asking the code level. Ragni?
Yeah, I'm asking code level only. Okay. Actually, this code level things and all, we are covering in some other part of training or how
it is? Yeah. I think that code level we are not covering as of now. As of now, how we will configure the JSON and localization, those things only we are covering.
We have the session on that also, right?
Yeah, it must be there. It will be there. Right? Malti?
Okay.
Malti, you are there?
Some network issue maybe.
Yeah, she got disconnected, I think.
Murli, meanwhile, can you show the UI screen also?
In between got disconnected.
Okay.
I was explaining like on load, we are loading all the details from the database. Here, if you see in the inspector, it will show
Madhi, the messages. You need to share the screen actually again.
Oh, it is not shared. Okay. Okay. So now we are able to see?
Yeah.
Okay. So on load of the application, we are loading all the messages from the DB. So here, if you see in the inspector, it will show Hindi, English, and whichever the language, one more Kannada. Okay. For Kannada, there are no push details pushed. It will show up like this. So when we change the languages, so it will pick from here. Okay. So these are the endpoints that are available to perform this update, insert, and then create. So if you feel UI also, I'll show up. That will be very user friendly. So I will log in as one more tab. And
so this is the part of super ending.
That localization we have enabled for, we have mapped it for super user. So this is the screen recently developed. Okay. So here you can see. So on load, it will show up all the available localization messages. So we will try to look for this We'll see whether there is a data for this key. There is no data. If you see, EM. See, there is a data, messages, language, locale, and module. So now we will try to add that for Canada. So add. KN. So message I will mention as Canada. Module Rainmaker. Locale. No. Only it will not list the list of languages.
It will show how it will show means whatever the filter you we have selected, right? That only it will show actually.
Oh, if in the I search want filter. To push for English, okay.
Yeah. Not here.
Change it to Canada.
In the local, no. In the local, in the search is there, right? Search above, go above actually. There is a search is there. There English is selected. If I select,
okay, if
you have.
If nothing is selected, by defaultly English.
Yeah.
Okay, I'll reset and try.
Okay, can you select the common? Common also there? Module name? Can you do the search? Okay.
I'll reload the sheet. Somewhere it is.
Local instrument to Indian.
This is not there. I will try to add. I think you are supporting English and Hindi. I will do it from back end. This is the locale, KNIN. So I put it in capitals, KN. Invalid access token.
Locale should be in small letters, right? KN underscore IN.
KN is small, IN should be capital.
IN should be capital.
Yes. Send.
Actually, you are calling the service in the some other gov.in only name. You are.
I changed it. I think I changed for only search endpoint. Yes. Thank you. Now it should work. Okay, it's added now.
As it's read from the cache list, or do we need to clear the cache?
We want to know, like, what all tables are involved in this localization in PostGIS.
It is only single table, message table.
Okay.
Hmm? So this is the table, message table, and it will have all these many keys. Okay, ID, local, code, message, tenant ID module, and then the user details, date and user details. Okay, it's not reflecting.
Malti, actually, we are loading, when we are loading the page first time, it do the cache in browser level on, right? So maybe
yes.
It's a store in that.
No, I just did hard reload.
Okay.
Some caching problem. That will come.
Malti, what happened?
Malti? I added for that Kannada. For local KNIN. So I added
okay.
In English only. Okay. The code is same.
Okay.
So I just did hard reload.
Okay. Might be it's not in the search, is it coming? API search? Otherwise you can search in the screen also.
API search, it is not coming. It is not showing up this Kannada. I think it is limited to English Hindi only.
No, it should do support. I will cover in my session that thing actually. I will cover that thing, that screen.
Okay. No, in Kannada it is not pushed. I think it is not pushed.
I think some problem with Kannada mostly. I think that is not tested.
Mm-hmm.
Hindi example only you can give actually. Hindi. Any missing Hindi.
Yeah, I'll show in Hindi. Sorry. See here for Hindi, we have action test localization, which is not pushed in Hindi. In English, it is pushed. So in English, it is localization. So we will do an online conversion of that label. Okay. English to Hindi. Here I will say localization. So this is the Hindi value for it. Okay. maybe this Kannada didn't work because I'm providing the value in English. Yeah. HIIN, and the code which we are pushing is for so in Hindi. Action underscore test underscore localization is the key. Yeah. Action underscore test underscore localization. Fine. So the code is this message, module, and locale. See, for this localization screen, there is no values pushed in Hindi. The same is fine for English because it is pushed for English.
Mal, can you try from the screen only one?
For Hindi?
Hello? Yeah. Can you select module name is common in the localization screen only?
So you want me to try add it from here only?
Yeah. Over. Yeah. And Hindi. And click on search.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. So now we'll search for that particular key action. Test underscore localization. It is not there in Hindi. It is there only in English. Okay. So we will copy this key. The key remains same for all other languages. So we will do addition. Only it's still showing English as default while adding.
Okay. Can you search that call is failing or something? Means you click on the search first. You click on the search button, right? Can you check that call is going or not?
It's still pending. No, it is successful actually.
Can you click once again?
No, it is not showing up Hindi values.
Okay. Can you search? Now English only is showing. Okay.
Not sure.
Okay.
Yeah. So I'll try adding from the endpoint only.
Okay.
Okay. These screens are recently developed and it is still under testing. So.
Okay.
Okay. So I'm using an endpoint. Action test localization. So there is no value for Hindi. So I'm pushing it here using upsert. Invalid access token.
Maldi, like when we do the customization, if we do have to modify the hot token for each and every request, it will be too much cumbersome, right?
No, not each. I think sometimes in between I logged out and logged in, right?
Okay.
So the previous token would be invalid. Okay, action test. The call is successful. It should reflect here now. Okay. If I change it to, okay, I will reload the screen. See, so localization we added as Staniyakaran something. So it is reflecting. Able to see it, the changes? Previously it was showing code, action underscore test underscore localization. Okay. So now, since we push the value, it is reflecting here. So similarly, we have to add all this. It is assumed that if it shows code in the screen, the localization is missing for that particular language. And after you add, if you refresh, it will reflect.
So general practice is either we use API or this UI in the application, right?
UI is a recently developed one.
Okay.
So through UI also we can do. Currently UI is allowing he will do all other fixes, whatever the issues are there. So in that sense you can do via UI or from the endpoint. From the endpoint there's a provision at once in a bulk you can push. Okay, in JSON format. So in the UI also is giving flexibility to upload the JSON file. Okay.
Okay, okay. And we don't touch the database. I mean, we don't directly access the database and insert it manually. That is not a practice, right?
That is not a practice.
Okay.
That leads to error in case if something is missed out. So if you do via endpoint, if any validations issues are there, it will show up here.
Okay.
Okay. And this code should be unique. And be careful while pushing data specific to state and specific to ULBs.
Okay.
This tenant ID, it should be properly mentioned if you are doing ULB wise data.
Okay.
So far clear, like how to enable new language and how to add keys and value pairs.
Yeah. So best way is to do the thing is we add a new language where it will show all the keys and then we can see the back mapping. Right.
Yes. So for a new language, at once you want to load it, query for English language, get all the keys and provide the messages for it instead of doing one by one, and that will be quicker. So whenever a new feature comes from the product, so they will provide us the English value along with the keys, localization keys that is used for that features. Okay. And what we will do for those keys, we will add in the or any other language specific values. And as we see in our applications, we have a notifications. Okay. SMS notification, email notification and WhatsApp notification. So currently what happens, by default English will be supported, and the notification will go in a language which is chosen here. Okay, if I mark it as Hindi, choose it as Hindi, and if I make a TL transaction, so in that case whatever the notification that gets sent during the workflow of the TL creation, it will go in Hindi. If I'm doing it in English, it will go in English. Okay, so there is a further going on, there is an improvement, like at employee level, we have to enable a default language where irrespective of this language, whatever the default language the employee is mapped, the notifications will be sent to that language only, in that language only. So that is the upcoming feature, but currently what is happening is all the notifications, everything will be sent in the language which is chosen while creating that transaction. Is this point clear?
Yes.
Okay. So again, you want to see the service. It is again a part of the code service. You can see there is one service called ego localization. So you will get all the contracts and the REST API collection also. So any questions so far?
Malti, as said yesterday, where is the contract details? You said you'll just show it. Where do we find it actually?
There's a doc folder actually. Docs. See local location, localization contract. Here you can find it. This YAML.
Okay.
Okay. So to enable application in particular language end to end, so you need to push each and every specific value. Okay, see here we have all drop down so and so. If I change it to anything, see, so for each and everything there should be a value pushed. Okay. So there will be some data where it will be a fixed one. See, this is Omkar Iga, which is an employee name, okay, which is added while creating the employee. These details cannot be changed. The DB values, okay. So. Any doubts?
Not from my side.
So, can we get back to yesterday's few points which were not answered?
One thing, can you share this like Postman collection?
Collections? Yeah, sure, I'll share. Fine, shall we continue with yesterday's that role mapping navigation related issues,
yes.
Questions were there. Okay. So those things Murli will take over. Murli.
Malti, you have said, told about this contract in docs, workflow 2.0.
Huh.
That one only? Yours is different folder actually. I'm able to means.
You're checking under?
I'm checking under e-government core services.
Okay.
Wait, this service is there.
They're not finding the doc folder?
Means in that one folder is there, but that doesn't have all the things.
Okay, I'll check and I'll share it. Maybe some other path it is placed. Okay, Murli.
Malti, let your screen sharing only. Okay, let them ask a question. I will go with this screen. Uh-huh.
Since mine is recording, if you share, I think it will not record. I'm not sure. Okay. I will show up the screen, you explain.
Okay, sure.
Yeah. So here. How we are loading menu tree from this action test JSON.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Can you open the action
test?
Oh.
I'll take up trade license. I'll show that screen and as well as you relate it here. Trade license, how it is loaded. Okay, this trade license, search trade license, and we have trade license report. So how this menu tree navigation is from this action test. So I will.
Malti, so I guess if you want, you can give screen sharing to Murli as well, because the call is being recorded. So I think anyone who shares screen can get recorded.
Oh, then it's fine.
Yeah.
Murli, shall I stop sharing?
I have some issue in the sharing, that's why I asked you. Let it be here only. Okay, I will explain. Can you open the action? Can you open the action? That related action?
This one, there are two. 1690.
Yeah.
1778.
What is the logic behind on the this menu tree is, okay, you can see there is a path is there, right? Path. We can see there is a path is there. Okay, path property. This is not the one multi. Can you open the last one here only? There is a trade license related. Here you can see ID number 1690, right? There is a one path is there. Correct, right? The path is there. The path is nothing but that is a menu path actually. Something like if you want to do the nested menu, right? We will split by dot actually. Okay. There is a trade license dot is there. That's why trade license is a main menu. Okay. Dot application is a sub menu of the trade license. Okay. And you can see there is a left icon is there, correct, right? That means what is the icon you want to give for the application, that left icon, you can, there you can mention the icons actually, okay? And also there is a navigation URL is there. For example, if I click on that menu item, right? For example, application menu item, if I click on, where I have to navigate, that URL we have mentioned in the navigation URL. Okay, that is about the menu part. Rest all the things you can just ignore actually. Just ignore. Means these are the three main part. And also if you want
the URL attribute is also optional, right? Then
URL means URL means URL always should be URL only, because then only we will consider as a menu. That action is belongs to menu actually.
Sometimes it mentioned with the different values actually other than URL.
It was card yesterday.
Okay. This is for internal API calls, right? In case if it is not related to menu tree.
Yes. Okay. Let me put it into in this way. This actions is there, right? There we are having multiple action actually, thousands of action. These are related to menu of the URL, and also some service. We are having many services in the backend, right? That services also we are included here only. Also, Malti, can you go back to the screen, home screen? A home screen of this application. Here you can see the property tax and trade license and miscellaneous collection cards, right? That also derived from that actions only. Okay, you can see wherever can Malti, can you go back to the actions? Okay, wherever you are seeing URL equal to URL, that is belongs to menu item. Okay, wherever you will see URL equal to card, okay. Aldi, can you find out URL equal to card something?
Yeah.
Okay, this is belong to that card. The card is printing the home screen. Okay, there is no URL. You can assume that is a backend service.
So if the URL is with some actual API call, it means that it is a backend service.
That is the difference. URL equal to URL means it's a menu item, and URL equal to card is belongs to the card actually, whatever home screen we are seeing, and whatever URL is having the service name, you can see service name, right? Some URLs having the service name, and it won't have the path actually. Path is something like empty. That is the difference actually. Three types you can assume.
So query parent is also related to internal service only, in which the URL is mentioned.
Yes.
Okay.
And then we have three levels like trade license report, receipt register. Okay.
Yeah.
So in that case,
Yes, yes.
You can take this property tax also, but property tax menu is not there, I guess. There, there is a trade license report.
This is cancelled. Okay, property tax PT reports. Okay, this is also three level path.
Three level. Yeah.
So in between this gap is there. See if you see there in the
property tax report, cancelled receipt register.
Okay.
So here. This one use case.
We just do the split by dot and whatever how many the items will come, that many nested this one will come. We no need to worry about that place space and an election.
Okay, okay.
That is just this one.
Okay, again for this we need to push localization values, right? PT reports,
yeah. Can you select the Kannada language? You can see that. Yeah, okay, name actually, what is action underscore test underscore is a prefix actually. Okay, after that whatever will come we'll just add it actually, whatever will come in the action.
It is go in this way, action test file name, actions underscore test underscore this property tax, what you mentioned, property tax underscore PT reports underscore cancel receipt register.
My confusion was, can you just can you just go back to that screen? See here, URL is also present
screen.
And navigational URL is also present.
Okay, can you go back to that?
So URL is rainmaker-pt receipt register. For cancel receipt register, it would be this. That's because we are getting these reports from the YAML, configuration YAML. Is it because of that only, like URL and navigation URL?
Is this action is there actually? Is this, can you take, I think this is might be a wrong action actually, might be using or not, I don't know that. Can you go back to the menu item? Is this report is there? Okay.
Okay.
Can you find out the trade license report actually? Okay. Can you go one second? Can you come down actually? Come down 1784.
1784 means ID is
1784.
Okay.
Okay, here you can see this is the correct action actually. URL equal to URL. Okay, I can see the path is that thing actually. The two level path is there. Navigation URL is nothing but once you click on the button, what will be the route will come into the URL. That will be the thing. I think that is the might be this is the which environment this is might be UAT, might be some action dummy actions are added by mistake. That URL might be added actually. We will come back with that actually, why that added might be the wrong or check with the team and we'll come back.
Okay. And yesterday when we were checking trade license as such, we didn't get the entry. Trade license dot report and all that, we were getting the entry in this action test.
Okay.
That is main menu and it doesn't have any action, so we are not keeping it. is trade license. Back trade license main map, main name. The first name is trade license. For this we didn't get the entry, right? In the actual test. Only for trade license.
Can you click on the search menu, Malti? Can you click on the search menu?
So it's telling like path we have trade license dot application. This is for search. So he's asking, is there a separate entry to show this first level hierarchy trade license?
Or yeah, is it a part of
can you click on that? Okay, can you click on search trade license? Okay.
Can you copy that trade license as such?
That is nothing but this 1690. And
this is related because employee and citizen will have different action for same screen actually. That might be a confusion, might be raised actually. Might be.
Sorry.
Same screen, the employee and citizen will have different path actually. Means path might be search screen is called in the citizen is application, and search screen is called in the employee call, employee as a search only. Okay, that might be the confusion.
My point is, see, if you see the path, it's here, it's a trade license slash something. Okay, I'm saying, path previous one, where the trade license dot application is mentioned, path equal to trade license dot application. So for trade license, we don't have any entry as such in name wise.
There is that. Path is there, right? Trade space license.
Application is there. For only trade license, main menu. We couldn't find the entry yesterday, right? Malti, can you search it? Only for trade?
Vipin, Murli, is my this thing is correct? Like, whatever the first level, it will consider as the parent module, right? The initial
Hierarchy. Yeah, correct. So yes,
we will not push it separately for that.
No. Okay. That is the main. Malti, there is a two instance actually. Can you search again? There is a two instance. This is related to the card, and that is related to the menu actually.
So here it's a trade license is there in card.
Yeah, this is a name actually, display name that will come in on top of the card actually.
That is for this one, right? This trade license.
So
wherever card is there, it is for this one, and on click of that, it will directly go to search. So that is why the navigation URL is this one and URL as a card.
Okay. And this card also displays as a main menu. Is it something like that?
No. So card will be for this right side of the application. Okay. So left side of the items, what happens is here we have a dot separated values, right?
Okay.
So it will pick the first level as the first level hierarchy, trade license as the initial one. First level hierarchy. So on click of that, the other things will be loaded. Okay. So here the second level would be this. Since it is, it should be shown in the UI, URL is URL and the navigation URL is this. Similar way for reports. If you see trade license, you can see trade license dot. We have trade license report.
Maybe TL report.
TL report, state level reports. TL reports, cancel receipt register report. TL reports, cancel receipt register report. So, but here in this case, we have both navigation URL and URL. So there is a, I think, separate session for reports. So reports we are not keeping in the backend. It is not coded in the backend. Okay. So we have a separate configuration repo where we are keeping these reports in YAML files. Okay. So I think this URL is pertaining to that YAML file path, and whatever things mentioned, I think this will be covered as part of that report session. Why there is two URLs for reports. Okay.
Again, this path will be saved as a master, will be pushed in master, you know, like key path equal to trade license. TL reports, again, it will be a different key.
Wait, I'll choose Kannada, then we can link up.
Okay.
The action test TL underscore reports. So action test TL underscore reports.
Why TL
again for report? This to display this last so here we are keeping it as TL reports, right?
Okay,
so I set the naming convention or... of preparing a message.
Okay.
So wherever space or any other special characters is replaced by underscore. Okay, so the first level trade license to show up in the localization, this is the key used, action test underscore trade license. Second level is TL reports. So action test underscore TL reports. So it will not be like action report underscore trade license. It is not that way. It will pick the second level key mentioned here. So the action test folder name underscore TL underscore reports will be the name for this. On click of this, it will show up the last level items. So again, the naming would be action test underscore this cancelled underscore receipt underscore register.
Okay.
So for this, there should be a localization value pushed.
Okay.
Clear on the navigation?
Yeah.
Here in this, JSON, there are mix of like unwanted ones also. That's why it will create a confusion. So some cleanup is required. But how Murli explained, it will work that way. Okay.
Yeah.
For these, yeah, we will add it as the URL would be card.
Yeah, because might be sometime what will happen.
Continue.
Sometime what will happen, that path might be we have given trade license dot and reports or something, but the localization name value has given differently. Actually, that time the menu name will be different than the path actually. Okay, that might be the sometime that confusion might be there, but always you can see the path and do the things actually. Yes, Malti, you can continue.
You guys, any doubts on this navigation part? So don't go by this different value data. Go this way, like for cards, the URL should be mentioned as card. Okay, and it will not have the path or navigation URL, whatever Murli mentioned. So for the left menu tree, the URL would be URL. Okay, and for the internal API calls, the URL will have the specific API paths. So these are the three main points you need to consider for this navigation.
Yeah, yesterday we had a conversation. Are you able to hear? Hello?
Hello? Now it's clear.
Tell me. The trade license we are using the TL. Hello.
I'll come to that point.
Okay.
Hello,
okay.
Vipin, I'm audible.
Yeah, you are audible.
Okay. So this first question is clarified, right? Related to navigation.
Right.
Okay. So I'll move on to the other one where we had mentioned as TL under city module.json. So you were asking about that yesterday. So this is the mapping you were asking, right?
Right.
So it is just an assumption like TL would be trade license. For property tax, it is PT. For miscellaneous collection, we actually address it as universal collection. So it is UC. So by that way, it will be mapped. You can see for property tax, it is mentioned as PT.
Okay.
So UC is nothing but universal collection. So for PT, property tax, and TL, trade license.
Okay.
So, and then one more feature yesterday we had left is that multi-tenancy. Okay, I'll show that also.
I will add one point here actually, that thing. Currently we can take the state might be having hundreds ULB actually, okay. I will take some one year application. PGR might be live in only 10 cities, okay. That mapping we will do here only. For example, TL is live in 10 cities, that 10 city code we have mentioned here. And when you are applying the TL, those 10 cities only we will show there in the drop down actually. That is the difference. This one, city model, yeah.
Yeah, this I've explained like yesterday. Yeah. This, they had doubt. Anywhere else explicitly, are we keeping the mapping like for trade license, it would be PT. So he had that doubt.
Okay.
See, here for Punjab, we have three languages, English, Hindi, and Punjab. This Punjabi. So here, as I said, like multi-tenancy in the sense, one employee can be mapped to multiple ULBs. Okay, and then each role may differ from ULB to ULB. So that drop-down will be shown here. Okay, so this feature is not taken in Uttarakhand, so you will not see that drop down itself. The UI is entirely different when we compare to this and this. So there is no separate ULB drop down shown here because it is directly mapped to only Haridwar ULB. So there is no multi-tenancy enabled here. So if it is enabled and if the user is mapped to more than one, it will list here. If to, otherwise, it will show the base ULB which he is mapped. Okay. So how this mapping is done? The way we do role mapping while creating employee, similar way it is done during the employee creation. Okay, and then if I switch to the other ULB, so now is base it is Amritsar. If I shift to Punjab, it will ask confirmation message whether we want to change. So in Punjab, So when we change the tenants, he might not be mapped to all the modules. If we see in Amritsar, he was getting many items in the left side menu tree. That's because in that ULB, he was mapped to n number of things. So in this tenant, he is mapped to only these many. So when we switch over, whatever roles or actions mapped to for that ULB and for that particular employee, it will be shown. Okay. This is the thing for multi-tenancy, multiple tenants mapping. So if you log in, if I log in as other user who is not mapped. See, here it is not listing for him because he is mapped only to his base tenant is only Amritsar. So it will show up only that ULB. Any doubts, guys? Hello?
Yeah, actually clear, Asish.
Yeah.
Madhi, I was checking for the collection, universal collection SH folder. I'm not finding in the Git repository. So can you please tell for mcollect what is the actually folder name?
In the MDMS.
MDMS or any UKD or anywhere.
Once again. So MCS, there is no like exact. That module specific master data is not there. So that's why there's no separate folder here. Okay. So whatever we are using, I'll show MCS, miscellaneous collection. So here only, these are the user data, mobile number, consumer name, to date, from date. And then only the drop down we show up is the service category.
Yeah.
These two are the MCS fields. So this we are fetching from the common masters. I will show you that.
Okay.
Admin fees.
Common master, right?
Ad hoc. So these service categories are nothing but the tax sets, like for which we need to make a collection. Okay, admin fees, finance, other fees, so on so. Murli, for MCS, we read this tax period from tax head master or any other master?
Here only, this tax, the tax head, here only it will be
there. Here only, right, yeah.
Adopt some taxes, might
you
adopt.
You can see, tax, true. Mutation fees, no dues, encroachment challan. So here we are using this tax set master to load this data, miscellaneous these two drop downs. Okay, since billing service is a core module, okay, and there is no it, and this is not specific to MCS. These values. Okay, and this we are fetching from this billing service only. So that's why you are not seeing any particular module with MCS. since we are using the existing masters. So, and whatever the data we are loading for these drop downs, it is named as ad hoc. Wherever you see ad hoc, it is for MCS drop down value. Okay, PT ad hoc means it is a rebate. The category is rebate. See. So that means rebate is not shown. But these two drop down values will be fetched from the Stackset master only. So all these are wherever it is ad hoc, it's for miscellaneous.
So here why we like we are using the name and then code with underscore something. Oh, okay. Got it. Leave.
Got it, right? So there is no.
Or it will be
so
in
if
common
any
master.
Particular. No, not common master. It is outside the common master. It is from billing service.
We didn't get all the data, right? We didn't get all the. Rebate part was not
this
there.
Is a user interval field. This is all.
Okay.
This is not
MDMS. The service
data.
Category we didn't
only
get
these
rebate.
Two are MDMS data, which comes from. We'll see for health. I'm checking the right only. Okay. Let me see.
Maybe if we change the language, we can directly get the name.
No, not for the name. I want to see which API it calls. Network is a bit slow here.
Malte, what happened?
Wherever here we have ad hoc, not all the values are getting shown in the MCS. Anywhere we are filtering in the UI, like we have rebate
okay.
here, right? Ad hoc
yeah,
rebate.
While, yes. In the while calling the API, we are passing some filter actually. Okay. You can go with some other type, whatever is there. Anyway, that is derived from that master only.
So we are reading values from this master, but based on some filter, right? Okay.
Yeah, all it won't come actually. I mean, some filter we have written in the UI, that long back written. I need to check what is the filter has written. You can go with whatever it's working, and we can.
So in miscellaneous connection collection, I just wanted to confirm what in all things that filter will be used. Okay, so because we have to first, our first deployment is on miscellaneous collection only. So that entry we have to make it, and according to that we have to master data also, we have to push it. So just wanted to confirm on that.
So if you have any specific categories and type should be pushed for your MCS, that data should go here, okay, in this taxed master JSON. Okay, and the naming would be, you need to add ad hoc.
Right, category and service, what particularly I have to specify?
So here this will come mix of both PT and TL, it will show up, right? So the same, this is not pertaining to only MCS. So we are using this JSON in various modules. So here we keep all the taxed master that is required. So there will be few specific to trade license, few specific to PTIS.
Right.
Okay. So for that differentiation, we are keeping the service. So, but for MCS, it will not go by service wise. It will go by this ad hoc.
Yeah, I agree.
If you go through the UI code, you will get to know the logic of how they are loading the data from this file with any other filters.
I got the point. I'm just saying, like, see, for trade license, we know these are the categories. For property tax, we know what are the categories. When I say the miscellaneous collection, means like a school fee collection. So this doesn't come under PT also, this doesn't come under TL also. So
wait, here you see, if you can see the tax, okay, for I am showing with respect to UKD.
Okay,
so here we have TL tax, name is just TL underscore tax, it is not ad hoc. That means this is specific to trade license module.
Okay,
so and then for miscellaneous, they have given they'll do collection for separate trade license, some taxes like on fly. Such won't go under the trade license workflow. Okay, such categories, again, it belongs to TL, but it will not fall under the trade license module. So it is for miscellaneous.
Okay,
so here we are keeping that ad hoc. This is for miscellaneous.
Okay, so in general, we will be doing the category, just to confirm it, in general, we will be putting the category tax and service as a TL, but when we are specifying the code specific to miscellaneous collection, we will be adding the ad hoc in the name and code,
ad-hoc.
Right?
Yes.
And this ad hoc will be passed as a filter from the UI, or it will be somewhere changed in the backend?
From the UI only, from the UI only.
Okay.
And then if you are doing any additional data, it is fine. And if you are adding any new dropdowns with new data specific to MCS, then you need to create that folder, MC folder, like how we have for trade license and property tax.
So what will be the folder name for that?
So it will be universal collection. Since we are keeping UC as the code.
In that, U is caps and collection is also capped. C is capped.
So only in case if you have any other details specific to miscellaneous collection, then it will go in the separate folder. Okay.
Okay.
So if it is any other data which belongs to any of these folders, then it will go into this.
Okay.
Any other doubts?
If you want to add any other subcategory, like there are two levels now, if you want to add another level, so you go into the same file?
It will be in the same file. It's not only that category and subcategory,
it will be dot. Yeah, it will be dot separated, I guess. The dot, dot will come.
See, you can see categories tax, maybe subcategory would be exemption, rebate, something like that. Yeah. So here,
dot separator is not there as such in that.
One second, I'll show you. See here, this is charges. So recently we added, if I see the history, so meanwhile, any other doubts, I'll keep checking on this, except this MCS.
Multi.
Common.
Multi, actually it is related with the localization.
Okay. Yeah, tell me, ma'am.
Actually, what happens now? Once in the beginning, we will have the by default English will be enabled.
Yes.
Then, once if we want to have one more language, suppose we want to have Hindi. Now, we don't have that in our system. So, we are adding Hindi also. So, as per if I am going via Postman, so in the request, I will be creating what all are the keys are required for my Hindi. And all the keys that I can push it as one stretch, correct? So
yes.
the data will be updated in the DB.
Yes.
Okay. So what happens once our application get loaded up? You told entire data from the message table will be read and kept in Redis cache.
Yes. Yes.
And we will be reading from cache each time instead of hitting the DB again.
Yes.
Correct. No? So once, suppose if I am adding a new data into my table, that means I have added a new key entry for my Hindi. Hindi entry, what new key is being entered, and it will be get reflected in the DB.
Yes.
And in that time, the cache will be refreshed, or when the cache will be get refreshed, because now the entry will...
Whenever you make that, I mentioned in the beginning itself, whenever make a new addition, the data gets added in the cache, means the cache will be refreshed.
Okay, that cache will also get refreshed and the data will be pulled from the cache only.
Yes.
Okay. Okay.
See, these minis, it is added for miscellaneous, so charges, tax, advertisement, hoarding tax, so ADVT. So these are only specific to MCS, so these are not related to any TL or PT, hence it is not having service as TL or service as PT. Okay.
Okay.
You can see advertisement fee, hoardings, Unipolis, gas balloon advertisement, hoarding tax, field fee, Unipolis, field fee, so on so. And for this, we will be pushing the localization. If I change it to Canada, I will get the keys. Advertisement hoardings, advertisement Unipolis, so and so. So here it is not looking for any ad hoc since it is specific to MCS only. So earlier we added ad hoc because the same tax was applicable in case of service PT in case of service TL, and same related to MCS. In that case, we mentioned it as ad hoc. So there are few categories which is specific to MCS only. So in UK, what we are doing, we are not loading those things. They have shared specific to MCS. So those are added here, if you see. So if you see here, it will go by this way. Advertisement, earnings. So ADVT, you see, ADVT. The naming convention goes by the folder name billing service and the master name business service and the code ADVT. ADVT is nothing but advertisement. So when you click on this, again, it's related data will be loaded.
So now in this case, how the mapping is happening, through the service name or through?
Service name only. See.
Normally we prefer the name and code, right?
Right. Billing service. Okay, I'll get back to code. Data. And okay. Billing service.
Business service. It's a part of business service then.
Okay. Type is ad hoc. Sorry, I think I was showing the wrong file. I'm so sorry. Murli, it is read from billing service. Okay. Yeah. See here, these values are there.
Yes, sir.
So the naming convention remains same. Billing service, business service, advertisement, and advertisement. See here. So billing service is the folder name, business service is the master name, and we are going by code. So here it is dot separated means two levels of hierarchy, parent and child relationship. So it will pick for parent, it will pick till here, and for the child, it will take the entire thing. See, advertisement, it is for parent. So on selection of that, it will get loaded. Okay, and here
the code is there, and above that line business service is there. Now what is business service in this means? What is, because each key matters actually in your case, right? So business service is again some convention to look, means present the UI or again in some module which is wrapping this. Means in the front end side, we are not able to see what is a business service.
Okay. Murli?
And even it's separated by node.
Okay. There was a confusion in tax sets and the business service. That's why that is shown actually. Okay. Business service is nothing but, if I take on the PT, right, when I want to make a payment in the PT model, okay, that time some condition will become the, can we do the partial payment or can we do full payment, and whatever the payment modes will support actually. Those are the configuration will be there in the business service actually. Okay, those are the configuration. You can see here, you can see some of the fields, part payment allowed, false is there actually. Okay, depends upon this configuration, payment screen will differ actually. Okay. You can see here is advance allowed. Okay. You can see after while doing the payment, right, you can see some options actually. What is the amount? Okay. There is a partial payment card is there actually. If it is true here, you will get the partial payment card there actually. Okay. And like that, some validation kind of things actually. For example, by mistake, the user entered the something like 1,000 rupees the payment if the user is entered 900 rupees actually. Okay, that time the API will read this configuration and it will return us if the partial payment is not allowed actually. Okay, like that configuration we will keep here. Yeah, that is one point. And also you can see three credit card and debit card, and those are the option means way mode of payment we can pay for the this model actually.
Okay, so it depend on gateway or it here we have to mention each and every. For example, tomorrow if we are doing the UPI also we will be mentioning that.
Can you come again?
See, actually in that you have mentioned credit card, debit card and one more option. So normally we write the gateway or we, like from here on it will be decided what mode is permissible. Like tomorrow if we add the wallet. And so that also we have to make an entry.
Yes, you have to make an entry. Okay, these configurations were read by both front end and the back end actually. For example, who are directly making using the API and making the payment, for example. Okay, at that time also the service level it will read this configuration and it will check the partial payment is allowed or not, and if they made the mode is something like DD, okay, that time it will check DD is presented in the collection modes allowed. It will check that way actually. Okay, that way we will use this configuration. Both the side we will use actually, in the front end and back end also.
Okay, normally we prefer write as a payment gateway, right? Then in the payment gateway, it will be decided what and all option do we have. Because if it's a 7-8 categories are there, then it will become like each and every category you are specifying.
Yeah, here too, where we are having the payment section. For example, if I'm an employee, I can collect from cash, okay. DD, and this one as a counter employee. Okay, if I'm a citizen, means I will directly go to the third party payment gateway. There I will select the what are the mode we are going to pay. Actually, it depends upon the which payment gateway we are going to integrate. Actually, that depends.
This is for employee.
Yeah. It means for example, we don't know who will. Which all are the way the data will come into our system, right? Might be directly some APIs, some people will use directly API, right? That time we should be securing the both the way. Okay. For that, this configuration is helpful.
Okay.
Means it's not particular to employee as citizen. Both role we are referring the same configuration. But depends upon the screen actually. Depends on, if you see the payment screen of employee, it will be different than the payment screen of citizen actually. That time you will get to know some idea.
Okay.
Vipin, clear on that? Yes. Okay, there was a confusion between the files, I'm sorry. But whatever the explanation given on tax period holds good, but that will be used in different place, not to load this drop down.
So for universal collection, we will be finally using the business service.json file, right?
Yes, to load the drop downs. So this is for rather writing back end calculation service part, but this Hadoop is for miscellaneous only. Okay, whatever I explained with respect to Taxed Master, again, it holds good. But this is not used for loading those drop downs. So it will be from the billing service, JSON.
Okay.
So your additional values should be added here.
Okay. Yeah, billing service as such in mCollect, it will be used or again, that part. Omkar will be sharing, right? What and all service are getting used for deploying the mCollect. Okay.
Yes.
And based on that, we have to decide whether we have to add in something in Text Headmaster also or not. Okay.
This service also. Okay. So any other doubts?
Is it possible for you to share the like URLs of like now whatever you are using either, and some login credentials, like dummy login credentials, so that we can play around and we can see how the data is coming. And
yeah, there is a playground environment.
Those credentials.
I'll let Omkar know. He can share it with you people. So this is with Rift, since it had all the data I was showing Uttarakhand. This cannot be used. I will share one more, the playground environment, which can be used.
Sure, thank you.
So if things are clear, we can wind up the session.
So you will be sharing these like even Postman collections also to Omkar only, right? And recording also, recording reference.
Recording reference and Postman collection. Okay, I will share it. Currently, I used upsert and search. This create, delete. Yeah, you can verify.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you, guys. Thanks.
Thank you.
I'll stop the recording then.
Yes.